Okay. We're here. Monday. It's early. It's raining. Not the best way to start off a run, not gonna lie. It's getting wet, but it is what it is. I'm gonna leave the phone here at home.
How good you going? Yeah.
To get started. It took me over like 15 minutes to find my damn shoes because they're in the front of the house. But anyway, it's neither here nor there. I'll see you guys in a bit. Peace.
All right, so we've showered. We got dressed. Great outfit. We're now doing some work, waiting for the kids to wake up, sticking to the schedule. Super important. This is probably the most important thing moving forward. If you don't plan your days, if you don't have them scheduled out, if you don't have every block set, it's gonna be difficult, especially if you have goals you wanna reach. So, I use a notebook. You guys probably use your phone. I'm just not tech savvy yet with that. I am, but I've actually got a better plan for when I get the laptop, which is coming in almost 3 weeks, because wife leaves today, and then she comes back March 7th, something like that. So anyway, we're working, we're having fun. I'm staying quiet because everybody's still sleeping over there. So hopefully you guys can hear me, and I'll see you guys in a little bit.
So this is pretty cool. It's the first time since I've been here. It's been almost 6 months, and it's looking like, knock on wood, it may rain all day, which would be amazing because of how cool it is when it rains. The family's still sleeping. I just went through some training videos, so that's good. They're still sleeping. It's 10 o'clock. That bothers me a little bit, but it's okay. A long travel day for Lily. The boys need their rest, so I'm not gonna complain about that. I'm excited. I've got a call in, let's see, it's 10 right now, so 11, 12, 3 hours. That's gonna be important. And it's President's Day back in the US, so I can't make any cold calls. I can make cold calls, but it's not really worth my time. So I'm gonna operationalize what I have to do with the other side business for the doctors that I wanna work with. And what else was I about to do right now? I brought my computer out here for something, but I forget. Anyway, it's just gonna be a good day, even though it's raining. Most people are like, oh, rain is a bad day. No, not for me. I love it, it's great. That's it. So what are we gonna do? We're working on something. I forget what we're working on. Well, there's the news. I'll see you guys when I figure out what it is that I remember what to do. All right, we're celebrating. Long story short, I got a new opportunity. One that would, well, it's the same opportunity I've been working on for a while, but I finally got the okay. He's gonna put me on a sales call potentially with a client, or a potential client rather. It's very interesting. I made some realizations during this whole process. First of all, the sales skills that I have are much different than the current day sales skills. They're not different, it's just sales skills depend on the situation. So I used to work in healthcare sales for the longest time, and it was very data driven, very logical, not very emotional. So while people do buy on emotion in the healthcare space, they usually don't because they're so busy. They have so much going on. They just say, okay, what's the bottom line? What's the result? I'll do it or I won't do it. Yes, there is an emotional component to it, but not like it is in something like this. So this opportunity is something that I'm going to explore. Hopefully I do well with it. I'm sure I will do well with it. I have to get my mentality wrapped around being good with it. The individual on the other end of the line was telling me I am extremely hard on myself. Okay, cool. But now I know that. And since I know that, what am I going to do about it? I need to not beat myself up about it. I need to get around that. So I'm going to spend the next 2 days, probably 3 days, looking up YouTube videos on how to do it, practicing with other people, just going through the reps over and over and over again. So just something to share with you guys. Thought you guys might enjoy it, might like it, but get in reps, get your reps in, understand what your skills are and what your skills aren't, and then get better at the ones that you're not. Pretty straightforward. So I do have to make the boys bikes because we just got new bikes in for them. I have to eat some lunch because I'm hungry. And then I got to go to jiu-jitsu. So, ta-da. I just realized this is the most exciting thing that I've done in a little while. So I don't know why I didn't record me doing it. But the kids got some new bikes. One of them is already completed. Take a look at it here. With its bright orange, the plastic spokes, I'm not a huge fan of, but real rubber tires, which is good, it's a big benefit. Nice sturdy metal frame. I have no idea the company, because it's a Brazilian company. I have no idea, the instructions are in Portuguese, so I've just been kind of winging it. That's all I got for you. Somebody's trying to call me right now. I'm just gonna chill out here. We're gonna make a bike for, I don't know whose this is gonna be. I still have to put the stickers on it. Can't forget the stickers, bye-bye. Is it supposed to spin? It doesn't spin fully. So it's not a fully operationally spinny thingy, but that's okay. We're gonna have fun doing it anyway, and I'm sure the boys are gonna be excited. So, got a nice sticker on the side there already. Hook that guy up. And the seat adjusts up and down to different levels, which is really good, because most bikes, they have like two settings. I like this setup better. So hopefully the boys enjoy it and watch me build the next one. It's really dark in here. We almost hit a dog with my niece. We're going to Via Igreja.
Uh-huh.
We're going to bring her to church and then Via Jiu-Jitsu. So, hooray. We're going. See you guys later. I'll see you at Jiu-Jitsu when I get my butt kicked.
Oh!
Thank you.
Yeah.